Edugence is the data management system that Plano ISD uses to house STAR, TELPASS, MAP, and COGAT data, as well as administer and analyze local assessment data. Due to FERPA laws, we must restrict who has access to student information. This is the process to grant you access to Edugence data. For regular teacher accounts, the campus registrar must roster students to you in Teams. Edugence pulls the roster from Teams to create the account. Long-term subs in a vacant position works pretty much like a regular teacher. The campus registrar must roster students to you in Teams. For specialist positions, ESL teachers, academic specialists, counselors, principals, etc., we must manually create a full campus access account for you. For special education teachers, we must create a full campus access for you because you usually don't have students rostered to you in Teams. For long-term subs in a temporary position, we can manually create an account for you that attaches you to the teacher of record so that you can see what the teacher sees. For team leaders, if a principal requests it, we can give you access to more than just your particular students so that you can have access to the entire grade level. This is the Assessment, Research, and Program Evaluation website. You can access this website at www.pisd.edu/ARPE staff. In the center of the page, you will see that we have a section for Edugence. This houses all of the guides and videos that show you how to use the Edugence website. You will see a thumbnail and a brief description of that particular report. Then you'll see a guide and video that shows you how to access and use that information. You can access Edugence through an icon on your web desk, or by going directly to the URL at pisd.edugence.com. Your opening screen depends on your level of access to Edugence. Classroom teachers will see their classes, and campus administrators will see absences, alerts, and enrollment. One place that you'll go to often is the waffle icon in the top right-hand corner next to your name. Today, let's click on that waffle icon and first go to Reports. This will change the center of your screen to show many different reporting options. About halfway down the page, one of the options that you will see is Plano Assessments. Under Plano Assessments, you see Rosters and Combined Assessments. Today we're going to go to Student Assessment History. Student Assessment History is important because it will show many different data points for a student all in one place. On the top right, if you have full campus access, you can select to search by grade or by teacher. If you have teacher-only access, you will only see teacher there. You will select your campus, your grade, teacher, or class. You also have the option to filter. You could filter by special ed, emergent bilingual, economic disadvantage, or 504 students. In Edugence Reports, you must click the green button with a white arrow to run the report. Under a student name, you'll see the student's ethnic group in an orange box. Under this, you'll also see a colored icon. These special icons are for populations that the student may belong to. Hover your mouse to define the icon. Here you will know which students are special ed, 504, emergent bilingual, etc. You will see next to this 3 years worth of data for each student. Three rows of data. MR stands for most recent year, P stands for prior year, and P1 stands for 1 year before that. Next to each student, you will see several columns of data. The STAR columns show STAR data for the most recent years. STAR measures how well a student has mastered the grade level TEKS. STAR is color-coded by performance level. The color code is here at the top of the page. Red is for did not meet grade level standard. Purple is approaches grade level standard. Blue is for meets grade level standard. And green is for master's grade level standard. Next, we see COGAT columns. More training on COGAT is available from our assessment department. The COGAT profile is linked to the Riverside website, where you can get a full profile of the learner. COGAT tells us how a student learns best, not what they need to learn. COGAT also reports the standard age score in the verbal, nonverbal, quantitative, and the composite domains. The average standard age score is 100. The last few columns are MAP scores. MAP shows what a student is ready to learn. The MAP scale is from 100 to 300, from kindergarten all the way up through 8th or 9th grade. There is a relationship between MAP and STAR. MAP predicts how well a student will do on STAR. So the color code here is the same as the color code for STAR. In Student Assessment History, you can click on the student name to access the student profile. Any place in Edugence where you see a student's name, you can also access the student profile. The top row of icons allows you to navigate to see different data sources. The opening screen shows STAR results, TELPASS, COGAT, attendance, schedule, things like that. The STAR icon shows the STAR, EOC, and historical information for the student. Performance level, scale score, raw score, percent correct, percentile for each reporting category. Next, we see Plano assessments, which shows MAP scores, which are projected to STAR over time, all the way back from kindergarten. Underneath that, you're going to see COGAT data. You will also see district unit test or progress monitoring assessments, PMAs by percent correct, and reporting categories by percent correct. There is a guide and video about how to use the student profile and the student assessment history report as well. The student profile is available to parents through the parent portal. The class by RIT report is also available in the same place where we were just looking at student assessment history. This is also in that center section in Edugence after you click on that waffle icon and go to reports. Under Plano assessments, in the same spot we just were, is where you'll find class by RIT. This report shows you how to interpret the MAP data and turn it into TEKS that connect back to the curriculum that you teach. There is a guide on our website that shows you how to access and use this report as well. For those of you in grades K through 5, you'll be entering reading record, writing sample, and other data in the student portfolios to monitor student progress 3 times a year. There's a guide on our website about how to enter this data as well. There are many other reports in the middle of this page on Edugence. For grades 3 and up, you'll be using district assessments. There's a teacher dashboard to analyze your unit assessment and progress monitoring assessment data. For grades 3 and up, you'll also access STAR data, and you'll see some STAR reports in the middle of this page. And for emergent bilinguals, you'll be able to look at TELPASS data in the middle of the reports as well. So far, we've explored some of the reports that you will use in the center of your Edugence screen. We accessed all of these by using the waffle icon in the top right and then choosing reports. For those of you in grades 3 and up, another place you'll be going in the top right is the assessments module. Again, you'll be clicking on that waffle icon and then choosing assessments. This is where you will assign district-created assessments, unit tests in grades 3 through 5 in English or Spanish for reading, math, science, and social studies. For grade 6 and up, there are course-specific progress monitoring assessments that you will administer. In the assessment module, you will assign the test, assign accommodations, and monitor testing. You can also create your own assessments using a key only, the Region 10 item bank, or a STAR released item bank. On our Edugence page, there is a guide and a video on how to use this module. Also in the Waffle icon dropdown, you'll find other options. For example, the Interventions module and the GT module for PACE teachers. On the left-hand side of your screen, you'll see a series of dashboards. What is behind the dashboard depends on your level of access to Edugence. If you have teacher-level access to Edugence, many of the dashboards will take you to reports that are available in the center section as well. For example, the map icon in the dashboard takes you to class by RID. Portfolio in the dashboard takes you simply to portfolio. And district assessment takes you to the teacher dashboard. If you have full campus access, however, to Edugence, you will have access to a variety of reports that show results for your entire campus. There are guides for these reports on our website as well. Our website is your guide for Edugence, and you'll find a variety of tools and resources here. www.pisd.edu/ARPE staff. And then click on Edugence in the center of the screen. Here, look for thumbnails and descriptions of different reports that you may need. Search for guides and videos about how to access the reports and how to read them. Remember that we in the assessment department are here to support you as well. If you need help finding information, analyzing information, or using the data, please let us know. That is what we're here to do. That is what we're here for, and we are happy to help you. There are many ways to connect with us in the assessment department. Please reach out to us and let us know how we can be of support to you.